मॉर्निंग क्लास, टुडेज माय टॉपिक ऑफ प्रेजेंटेशन इज एटलेक्सटासिस। एक्चुअली व्हाट डू मीन बाय एटलेक्सटासिस? एज यू सी इट इज रिटन द कोलैप्स लंग, तो यू हैव सीन द राइट लंग इज यू नो वेल इन्फ्लेटेड एंड द लेफ्ट लंग इज कोलैप्स एंड इट्स साइज इज वेरी स्मॉल। हाउ दिस कंडीशन अकर्स, हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू इम्प्रोवाइज विद दिस कंडीशन एंड हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू take care of this patient, on this kind of patient, and what will be our nursing responsibilities. Atelectasis is actually nothing but it is a closure or collapse of the lung which will result in the reduced or there will be an absence of the gas exchange, and it can affect both lungs or it can affect a single part of lung, either it is left or it is right. Atelectasis is a collapse of alveoli or a lung tissue and it becomes airless. There will be not any kind of air present inside the lung and there will be an absorption of the air without replacement of air with breathing. You know, as you see the airway and the lung, what will happen? This one is the normal alveoli. This one is the normal alveoli and this one is the collapsed alveoli, because as you see the size is also reduced because there will be no gaseous exchange and the alveoli are collapsed. So it can be acute and it can be chronic because you know it occurs after the post operative setting, or the people who are immobilized and have a shallow monotonous breathing pattern, or the patient is having any kind of trauma. Obstruction of the airway will be there if we will consider about the etiological factor. If there is any kind of obstruction in the airway or diminished distension of the alveoli. Airway or foreign bodies, extrinsic compression on the airway, that is the compression due to large or aberrant vessels. Masses of the chest that compresses the airway and the alveoli, cardiomegaly or enlarged pulmonary vessels that compress adjacent airways. What will be the etiological factors for the atelectasis? There will be an altered breathing pattern or pain, alteration in the small function, anesthesia, or because of anesthesia or sedation it occurs, increased abdominal pressure, or if the patient is having a reduced lung volume due to musculoskeletal disorders, that is severe scoliosis, or pain from the upper abdominal surgeries will lead to this. Any kind of bronchospasm, any kind of abnormal airway secretion or cystic fibrosis, or the patient with the persistent low volumes, if the patient is having low lung volume, the patient may have this disease condition. If there is an abnormal airway clearance such as ciliary dyskinesia syndrome or if there will be a pneumothorax or hemothorax, excessive pressure of the lungs tissue, etc. If the patient is having a tumor or a cancer within the thorax, or due to which there will be an elevated diaphragm and collapse of lung occur. Excuse me. In pathophysiology, what will happen? There will be a reduced ventilation or any type of blockage which impedes the passage of the air. Now, when there will be a reduced alveoli, what will happen? Or if there is a loose alveoli, if there is a reduced alveoli, or if there is any kind of blockage, there will be difficulty in the passage of air, due to which the trapped air, which is absorbed into the bloodstream, but outside air replaces the absorbed air because of the blockage. You know that, like if you see that it is written that the trapped alveolar air becomes absorbed into the bloodstream. Whatsoever is the air or the blood is in the air is inside the alveoli, what will happen? That will be absorbed by the bloodstream. But the outside air cannot replace the absorbed air because there will be a blockage. Alright. So isolated portion of the lung becomes airless, due to which alveoli collapses. You know, you know, like if, if there is isolated portion of the lungs, it becomes airless and alveoli collapses. So there will be an excessive pressure on the lung tissue, which will restrict the normal lung inspiration or expansion, due to which the this lung or the alveoli becomes airless for a prolonged time or a prolonged period, due to which the alveolar collapses. The clinical manifestation, you know that if the patient is not able to breathe properly, what will happen? If the airway is blocked, what will happen? What kind of all respiratory symptoms will come inside the body or inside a human being when he is suffering from atelectasis? There will be a cough, there will be a sputum production, a low grade fever, because if infection is there, then definitely the inflammation will be there, and patient can suffer from any kind of infection, and patient may have respiratory distress. He will be anxious, he will be fatigue, the patient will feel fatigue, or pleural pain will be there, central cyanosis will be there, and there will be difficulty if you don't provide the proper positioning to the patient. All right, so what kind of position you will give to the patient? If you will see what will happen, like what kind of position will you give to a patient? The patient will be given a semi-pallet position, because in supine position it is very difficult to breathe properly. So here we discussed about the central cyanosis. What do you mean by central cyanosis? Central cyanosis means actually it is a bluish or grayish color of the skin or nails, lips, or around the eyes. Because it will be a kind of blue skin, because when the body is not able to inhale oxygen, or body is not able to absorb the oxygen, definitely where the oxygen supply is less, the bluishness occurs. Next is how we are going to do the assessment and diagnostic finding. So first of all, we are going to take the history and physical examination. As you know, we have to ask the patient that what happened to him, or is he was having any kind of disease condition either before. And then we have to go for the pulse oximetry. Then we have to check the saturation of the patient. Definitely the patient saturation will be less. Then we go for the chest X-ray. We have to see the patch infiltrates or consolidation areas. Then we have to see like this kind of image comes when we'll see an X-ray or a CT scan. We'll see like this is the black part of the lung where no expansion is there. Here's your heart and here's your lungs, and you see this part where no expansion of the lung is there. All right, so what will be the prevention? That is a frequent turning and early mobilization. Strategies to expand the lung and to manage the secretion. Deep breathing exercise or deep breathing maneuvers at least every 2 hours we have to provide to the patient. We have to ask the patient to do the deep breathing exercises. Use a spirometry. Directed cuff or suctioning or aerosol nebulizer is to be provided. Chest physiotherapy is considered. Postural drainage or chest percussion or bronchoscopy is to be given. Change patient position frequently. We have to change the position frequently, especially from the supine to upright position, to promote the ventilation, prevent secretion from accumulating. Now, we have to encourage early mobilization from the bed to chair, followed by early ambulation. Encourage appropriate deep breathing and cuffing to mobilize the secretion and to prevent them from accumulating. Administer prescribed opioid and sedatives. We have to ask the patient to give the opioids or any kind of sedative, so that the respiratory depression should be prevented. Then we have to perform the postural drainage and the chest percussion if it is indicated by the doctor. Institute suctioning to remove the tracheobronchial secretion if it is indicated. Then comes the management. The goal of goal in treating the patient with atelectasis is to improve the ventilation and remove the secretion. Actually, what is the goal? We have to improve the ventilation and we have to remove out the to remove the secretion. In the patient who actually do not respond to first line of drug, cannot perform deep breathing exercise, or the patient is in the ventilator, they have to go through the PEEP therapy, that is positive expiratory pressure. If the cause of atelectasis is bronchial obstruction, then obviously the secretion has to be removed by cuffing or endotracheal suctioning or tracheal suctioning to permit the air to re-enter into the portion of that lung. Chest physiotherapy is to be done, as I told you before. Nebulizer is to be given or bronchodilator is to be given. Medication or sodium bicarb may be used to assist the patient in the expectoration of the secretion. If respiratory care measure failed to remove the obstruction, bronchoscopy is to perform. I told you in the last lecture as well that bronchoscopy is meant by to visualize the bronchus. Alright, to visualize the bronchus where the obstruction occurs, so that we should see is there any kind of obstruction or not. Endotracheal intubation or mechanical ventilation is to be given to the patient. Thoracentesis is to be given. Can be done, or it is meant by removal of the fluid by needle aspiration or insertion of the chest tube if cause is compression. Bronchoscopy is to be done. Then nursing diagnosis: ineffective breathing pattern related to collapse of the lung tissue, activity intolerance. Thank you and have a nice day. If you have any query regarding this, kindly feel free to contact me. Thanks and have a nice day.